Welcome back, Colonels. Don't forget, EKU Libraries is here to help. In this tutorial, we will identify keywords in those questions, brainstorm alternatives, and create search statements that will help you use databases and academic search tools to find the sources, journal articles, eBooks, videos, and more you need to support your research project. You should have an idea of which research question you plan to use to guide your research project. While that question is the one you should use for the activities demonstrated in this tutorial, try not to get too attached to your first question. As you start searching for and reviewing sources, you may find the need to modify that question or even return to your research map for additional ideas or avenues for inquiry. With that said, let's get started. Take 5 minutes to grab a blank piece of paper and a pen or pencil, then write out your research question at the top of your paper. Pause the video here and resume when you're ready for the next step. Chances are you have used Google to search the internet for information. Google is easy to use. You can pretty much type anything and get results, even a complete sentence or question. Unfortunately, most of the databases and academic search tools that allow you to access the scholarly, academic sources your instructor wants you to use aren't quite as easy to use as Google, but that doesn't mean they are impossible. With a little pre-planning, you can get excellent results. What do I mean by pre-planning? While Google pretty much lets you type anything into the search bar, databases and academic search tools will work much better if you break your research question down into keywords. That is, distill your research question down to its major concepts and leave out all the filler words. Take our research question here, for example. What impact does social media have on the mental health of teenagers? First, cross out any filler words or words that do not carry specific meaning. What does have on the of are all out. That leaves us with impact, which is a little trickier. In the context of my research question, it represents the idea of the relationship between social media and the mental health of teenagers. However, outside the context of my research question, its meaning is not specific or unique, so let's cross it out too. That leaves us with three keywords. Social media, mental health, and teenagers. All three are keepers because they are specific and represent exactly what my research topic is about. If I completely removed any of them, it would change the nature of my research. You should have at least 2 to 3 unique concepts in your research question. However, some research questions might have more concepts. If you aren't sure of how many unique concepts make up your research question, consider asking for help from your instructor, a librarian, a Null Studio consultant, or even a classmate or friend. Now that we've identified our research question's unique keywords, let's write them out on a fresh piece of paper. In the next step, we will be adding additional ideas for each keyword, so make sure you leave room beneath each one. Basically, you'll be creating a keyword brainstorm table like the one you see here. Take 5 minutes to apply this process to your research question. Pause the video here and resume when you're ready for the next step. The three keywords we identified from our original research question are a great starting point. But what if the scholars who research and write about social media, mental health, and teenagers use slightly different keywords? What if instead of social media, they write about social networking? We want to be prepared to switch out keywords if we aren't getting enough relevant results, so we need to think of synonyms or similar terms, broader terms, or narrower terms for each of the unique concepts of our research question. For example, we've already identified social networking as a similar term for social media, but we might also want to think of narrower terms for social media. For example, we can consider particular social media platforms. Mental well-being and mental wellness are both terms I've seen used in place of mental health online. And I know that academic research is more likely to use the terms youth or adolescence for teenagers. This is especially true for researchers in psychology, where I would expect to find a lot of research on this topic. There is no magic number of alternative terms. You might think of several alternatives for one term, but only one or two for others. If you have trouble coming up with alternatives for any of your keywords, it might help to think about what fields of study would cover your topic and include the types of terms used in that field, like we did with psychology and teenagers to get adolescents and youth. Googling your topic to learn more about it might also help. While we don't often use blogs, Wikipedia, encyclopedias as sources in our research projects, sometimes they can help us find the right words for our research topic. Take 10 minutes to apply this process to the unique concepts from your research question. Remember, start with the keywords from your research question at the top, then list synonyms, broader, or narrower terms for each underneath. Pause the video here and resume when you're ready for the next step. Now that we have a good handle on our keywords, we need to create our search statement. But what is a search statement? Searching databases is all about combining keywords in a way that the database can understand and that will retrieve the most relevant results. This combination of keywords is called a search statement. Most databases use Boolean operators to combine keywords, so we need to use Boolean operators in our pre-planning by writing them into our search statements. Boolean operators link keywords together to either narrow or broaden your set of results. The two most common basic operators are and or. Using and to connect keywords in a search statement tells the database you only want to see articles that contain all of those keywords. Think all or need it to complete it. Using or to connect keywords in a search statement tells the database you want to see any articles that have either of those keywords. Think either one and the job is done. If we go back to the keyword brainstorm table for our research question, notice that we would want only research that contains all of the keywords across the top. That means we can combine those keywords with the Boolean operator and. If we stopped here, this is what our search statement would look like. But let's go back to our keyword brainstorm table and see if we want to bring in any of our keyword alternatives. Because the keywords listed under each of those original keywords are synonyms for the keywords above them, we might want to add some of those keywords to our search statement using or. But we might not want to throw them in all at once. Let's add the synonym for social media, social networking, and the synonyms for teenagers, youth, and adolescents. Remember, because these are synonyms, we add them to their matching original keywords with the Boolean operator or. So now our search statement looks like this. Take 10 minutes to create at least one search statement using your keyword brainstorm table. Remember, each unique concept, the ones across the top that came directly from your research question, is connected with and, all are needed to complete it, while synonyms are connected with or, either one and the job is done. Pause the video here and resume when you're ready for the next step. Now that you've identified your research topic's keywords, brainstormed alternative keywords, and created your first search statement, submit your work for all three steps. Then, when you are ready, head over to our next module to learn how to use your search statements to find sources using library databases. Need more help? Consider talking to your instructor, making an appointment with a Null Studio consultant, or chatting with a librarian to work on your keywords and search statements. Good luck!